This is what I'm talking about. We've been waiting for this for 3 days.
On this episode of Trying Something New, we are definitely trying something new. We are in the Florida Keys and we are experiencing our first ever tropical storm in an RV. And make sure you stick around to the end because we have not had a situation like this in a long time, maybe since we were in Thailand. And this is definitely one for the record books. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up and hit that subscribe button.
And now a tropical storm warning issued for parts of the Keys.
45 mile per hour winds.
Near 50
to 55 miles per hour.
We found out there's a tropical storm coming on the way, Tropical Storm Fred. And I've got a leak on the roof that we've had for a while, and it hasn't been raining for a while, but so we've been all right. But I think with a tropical storm coming, I better get out of my laziness and get to fixing the leak on the top. So the root of all of our evil is this skylight right here. Now this thing's probably been in service for over 20 years. This is a 1999 RV. As you can see right here, we got a nice little crack running all the way up. Each one of these is a crack. And these are all the ones that I fixed all the way around here. So that's the one I gotta work on today. So let's get going. So it's crazy to think in less than 24 hours, this place is gonna be madness. We got the water right behind us over here. And it's gonna be exciting, different, and hopefully safe to see what happens after this tropical storm hits. All right, so there's a little beach access area right here, canoe launch, and right outside of it is some boats, and we got a major storm coming here in the next day or two. So, man, I'd love to go out to these boats and just let them know, hey, if you need a little escape from the craziness, please let me know. Get out there. Maybe I get my paddleboard and paddle out to them and let them know before it gets crazy. So I think something we need to keep in mind is that mangroves are the key to safety. And I think a lot of times people forget about this, but you can see the root system down here keeps everything locked in place. And they also keep the wind from just destroying you. So mangroves are awesome. Let's see what we can do to conserve them and make sure they're around. Hey, you know what? We're talking about this guy and helping him out on the sailboat a while ago, but he's coming up on his little boat right now. So maybe we could offer him some of our services real quick, because I hate to see anybody out there, especially since we're getting ready to go out on a boat. That'd be kind of a cool cool segue.
That's what I'm doing. Yeah,
my name is Jimmy, by the way.
Jimmy? I'm Monty.
Monty, nice to meet you.
So you're same as you guys. We kind of wanted to unplug from the matrix.
Yeah, for sure, 100%.
And so first we RV'd. We hit all over the United States, Canada, and New Mexico in an RV. So started learning to sailing. Now we're learning to sail as a family on this little guy. That's called the Barbara Jean.
Okay.
And she's a trimaran. She's actually fully equipped. Yeah. We're pretty much noobs to sailing too. Like.
So are you nervous about the storm coming?
Well, that's what me and my oldest daughter are out doing right
now. And how long is that?
It is 31 feet.
They're, specialty.
All right, Sandy, what's going on here real quick?
Well, I don't know. I just came over to check on Jimmy, and I see him talking to somebody in a canoe.
They're actually getting kidnapped.
Yeah.
You don't even realize it.
So we met Monte. He's a fellow traveler, nomad, gypsy, and he's been RVing for a long time.
Well, you know, it's funny, is yesterday we just got here, and Jimmy goes, there's a catamaran out there. And I go, get out. And we look at it and go, is that a trimaran? And we're like, that looks super awesome. It's gotta be old, it looks super cool. And it turns out this is the guy that owns that boat. How random.
I think the universe brought us together because I was over here getting shots of his catamaran being a creeper. And then he came over here and thought I was waving at him.
We're like, should we paddle out to them and see?
I saw it's not very good. And I thought he was my wife.
Yeah, go for it. So Monte invited us to go check out his catamaran real quick.
So that's, hell yeah, we're gonna hump.
That's what we're doing right now. Oh my God, how crazy is this?
I feel like I'm back in Thailand.
This is kind of a, yeah, I can see that.
How are you liking the boat? I just did my hair.
What are you doing back there?
I don't know.
Oh, you're on a boat out in Florida Keys.
And a trimaran.
What was your name?
Bella.
Bella, I'm Jimmy. This is
nice
Sandy.
Hi, Bella. Sandy, nice to meet you.
We're out here getting ready for the storm, guys.
You'd have to have a snap, and a snap is the idea.
Yeah.
Because those anchors aren't gonna drag.
Are we dragging anchor? Or did it break, or what's going on? We gotta figure that out.
Even if they do drag, they're not gonna go very far. It's 8 feet for miles.
What's your goal with all this?
Our goal, we do have a goal. We want to grow closer as a family. We want to find out what God's telling us to do and then go do it, because we believe that that's the way to fulfillment.
So what a great experience. We got to come out here with Monty and his daughter and check out the boat and just feel it, man. Feel what it feels like to be out
here. Touch the dream.
Touch the dream.
I'm touching it.
All right, Monty.
Bye.
Absolute pleasure.
Touch the dream.
Touch the dream.
Touch the dream.
thanks for making our day.
Yeah, good to meet y'all.
Wow, back on land, Sandy. How's it feel to be back on land?
Oh, man, I want to be back out on the water.
Back on the water.
That was so fun.
It doesn't even make sense, guys. And that's what life's all about. It doesn't make sense. You just got to buy the ticket and take the ride. See where it takes you. That's what we're all about.
Put your seatbelt on, because you don't know what's going to happen.
Loving how you wind up for me. Tonight is all on me. Mash up the place for me. Yeah, yeah. She just wanna highlight. Ooh, we, that body talk to me.
All right, here we go, guys. A little lesson in music. Mommy and Daddy used to be hardcore ravers back in the day. I don't know if you know what that means or not, but
we
used to go to nightclubs and listen to amazing music. And this is one of our anthems when we were there. Sandy, what do you have to say about this?
Yes, that is very true.
You guys know the name of the song?
We gotta give these kids a taste of it. Oh.
Zombie Nation!
Sky, smile! One of the kids is not having a good time. All right, so we are running to the store right now to get our hurricane prepared list, shopping list done. Because, I don't know, this thing could change at any moment, and we want to be prepared. We're usually not very prepared people. So we're all working together, teaming up, and we're going to be ready for this storm. Guys, what do you think?
Yeah.
Are we ready for Fred?
Boo, Fred, go Jessica.
Alright, we just pulled up at Winn-Dixie and I think the tropical storm might be getting here already because this rain is bananas. Check it out.
So now that it's pouring raining, we have to get soaking wet to get into the store. Which you know, it's really cold in the store all the time.
I got it.
Alright, ready? Oh, it looks like it slowed down a little bit.
Go, 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 go. It slowed down.
All right, I guess it's my turn to run for it. I don't want to do this, but sometimes you just gotta go. Oh my God, I hope this camera makes it through the rain because this is not a GoPro. This is a Sony camera. All right, is it still working? Everything good?
There's water on the thing. I can't open it.
This is Storm Fred list.
It's a tropical storm party. Did you get it open?
I don't have enough bags, but at least we helped out the earth and saved animals and sharks.
Oh my God. The rain has gotten 3 times as hard, and we have to load up the car. There's no car! Oh my God! I got the best idea ever. So you know how Jimmy was strolling around the supermarket?
What do I gotta
and
do
I
now?
Did all the work? All gonna sit in the dry car, and Jimmy is gonna load up the trunk all by himself.
Okay, I'll do it.
What's the shortest path? Run, Forrest, run!
right, you guys are gonna go sit in the car. I'm gonna load all this stuff up.
No,
you guys
I need
ready?
Too.
Yeah, ready, come on.
Oh my God!
Get soaked out here.
Come on, down. Faster, faster. Oh, you slept, darling.
I am soaked to the bone. I hope I made it up to you. Let's go get some pizza and get home so I can unload it and get soaked again.
We need to get ponchos. Ready to go?
Yeah.
No. Are you hungry?
Yes. You hold this because I don't.
All right, we got about 10 seconds till we get fogged up here. Crazy adventure. We should be stocked and prepped for tomorrow.
We are ready for the weekend, baby.
Yes, let's see. The weekend, yeah.
Hopefully
it's Friday, Saturday, Sunday.
As long as Fred doesn't knock over the RV, we're good.
Wish us luck, guys. We'll see you tomorrow. We're going to wrap it up, finish up some pizza, unload this stuff, and watch some, let's watch some La Vagabond tonight. Does that sound
good?
Oh,
Sailing the Vagabond. We are,
ooh, lightning
we're
out there.
Digging you.
Yes.
One baby up pound. One baby up.
So this paddleboard flew off its little stand. So
we don't want this paddleboard to go to waste here, so we're going to go save it before the hurricane takes it.
You're doing a good deed, guys.
All right, we saved the paddleboard.
Good job, guys.
Save the board. Let's get to safety.
Woo! Woo! Hey, Rye, how you doing?
I'm tired.
Can I help what you an adventure, drive, huh, guys?
So today is the day the storm is officially supposed to hit. Today's Friday, so we got a little bit of rain last night, nothing too crazy, but tonight is supposed to be the craziness getting started. I'd say we're kind of nervous, kind of excited, kind of don't know what to expect.
Are you nervous about saying this?
No, we're going to have a Fred party.
Yeah!
Hey, of course you are!
So one of the things people like to do down here is have hurricane parties, so tonight is a Fred party. Time to get Fredded out. You guys ready to Fred it out?
All right, so as we ride around, it looks like a lot of people are starting to prepare. They're taking down their canopies, they're tightening everything. Oh my God, look at that one!
Yeah, we're gonna get that one.
Oh my God, or they're just leaving. We've seen quite a few people pull out. So hopefully we're not making the wrong choice by staying here, which we didn't even know was coming. So it's not like we had a plan B anyways.
You guys leaving or staying?
Oh, thanks, babe. Oh, I'm so hungry. And guess what? This little boy just came over and he is so excited because he watched some of our videos and he's never met a YouTuber before.
I just watched your YouTube channels. That's our RV. And I never been in a YouTube channel.
Oh.
All right, we'll put you in ours, okay?
Yes,
okay.
Well, nice to meet you, Autumn.
All right. Happy
you think we're going to get hit hard with this storm or what?
Mm-hmm.
Think we'll have any leaks?
Probably.
Tropical storm warnings have been issued for the Florida Keys. Here's the latest with Fred.
Wait, right
of Florida
there.
Through the weekend.
There we go. That's the latest update. It was a depression, and now it's going back up to a tropical storm, which means it gained momentum.
All right, so we're wrapping up day two here. We've been kind of waiting in anticipation all day for this thing to happen. And
it hasn't happened.
It hasn't happened yet, but it's coming. This is weird because it's all like, it's the calm
it's
before
like
the storm.
It's a perfect day.
Everybody's out having a good time. And I wonder if anybody knows what's about to happen.
Oh,
what was the next?
Dun, dun, dun,
dun, dun, dun.
The wind's picking up a little bit. We're going to get some ice.
Guster.
Tonight's coming. Here we go.
We rode out Hurricane Irma a few years back, and we had a condo right on Daytona Beach. So we were five stories up. Now, it was my wife's first time in a hurricane. So she was all freaked out. She's like, baby, we gotta leave, you know? And I'm like, just ride it out. We're on the fifth floor. We're going nowhere, you know?
So what do you think about this, though? What do you think about Fred?
This ain't nothing here. They're saying 35 mile an hour winds. Rain, we might get some rain, but other than that, it's...
That means...
Right. Spoken from a true professional.
Yes, an OG.
A Floridian who's been through a couple.
He's an OG Irma survivor.
We love him. It's just time to party.
See you tomorrow. We got our ice.
All right.
What are we watching here, guys?
Sailing Catalpa.
Sailing Catalpa.
What's that, Sky?
They're my favorite. I watched every one of their videos. Oh, my favorite video is when they went to land. By
the way. All right, let's see what this episode goes.
If you want to catch channel, that's the
about 7 in the morning. There's a beautiful sunrise happening right behind me. A little bit of drizzle. Last night we got maybe a little bit of rain. Some lightning storms are going out in front of the RV. But if this is all we got to worry about, then I think we're in good hands here.
Look, I'm in line with the stars. I'm in sync with the earth. 10 toes deep, flower child from the turf. I never switch sides.
Why is your leg hanging out the window?
Well, I am not doing so good right now. Not too close, no makeup. Yesterday it came down with something. I'm pretty sick. And so if you notice, Jimmy is pretty much the whole rest of the video. It's because I'm laying here trying to recuperate.
All right, hope you get better.
Thanks.
So not only am I taking care of my lovely wife over here and the kids, and I'm editing full time and out shooting everything. So, and I got to have it done by tonight because this is got to post tomorrow. A sip till I pass out. Try and get grip, but it don't make sense. Cause you can lose life. Yeah, here we go. This is what I'm talking about. Oh my god, there's a one wheel right here.
Better put that under the thing.
Alright. This is what I'm talking about. We've been waiting for this for 3 days. Now we're gonna come out and get some damn shots. Woo! We got it! Alright, Ryder went to the store. And I gotta go find him. Alright. I feel like that scene from Forrest Gump where the guy's up on top of the mast going, "Is this all you got?
You call it the storm!"
I found him! I found Ryder! Come on, buddy! Alright, Ryder, make it home safe. I'll see you in a minute. Alright, everything's getting wacky out here. The seas are turning. The skies are gray, the trees are blowing.
Tell your friend Greg not to stick around either.
So this is about the time when things get interesting because my microphone is soaked with water and the wind is blowing about 40 miles an hour. I looked out on the horizon and saw the Barbara Jean, the trimaran that I had been on the day before, just floating out in the middle of nowhere. So I took off running to try and go find Monty, the owner. I found his daughter Bella and she said this would make for some great content for a YouTube video. I like the way she thinks. Right. What do we gotta do?
I ain't doing nothing.
I just saw a boat just haul ass out of the harbor.
I don't know, is there any way to get out there?
No.
Your little boat, your little motorboat?
I ain't doing nothing.
The kids had all gathered around and we were trying to figure out how to get out to the boat to save her. I knew this story was gonna be epic and I had to document it, but just then I looked down at my GoPro and saw my battery was at 3% and my memory card only had 4 minutes left. So I had to hightail it back to the RV and get back in time to catch the story.
A few moments later.
Got a memory card in. Let's go see if we can find these guys. Woo. All right. Looks like the boat's about another 150 yards out, so see what happens here. What's the plan? Everybody got a plan?
Yeah, maybe this boat can give us a ride out.
Just when we had about given up all hope, a magical boat appeared from the darkness.
Necesitamos, vámonos para the boat.
They spoke a little bit of English and I spoke a little bit of Spanish and we figured out how they could help us.
And
without hesitation, we hopped on the boat and we were off to save the Barbara Jean.
All right. All right, these nice gentlemen here can give us a ride out to get it. Gracias.
What do you think, man? What do you think?
You got my phone?
Bro, I'm not thinking, I'm just acting right now.
This boat felt like it went 0 to 80 in about 3 seconds.
Holy crap, that was fast.
good driver, huh?
Yeah, he's a good driver.
Okay. Yeah, take that.
Without these guys' help, there was no way we could have got on the boat.
Okay.
See you, man.
Adios. Que numero?
So let that be a life lesson to us all. If you see somebody in need of help, stop to help them, because in this case, you could just save their boat.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. I'm getting all the surveys those guys
did not. I'm going to check the anchors here. Okay. See if we got anything still down. No, oh, Jesus Louise. Woo! That'll get you pumped up.
All right, so before we get started here, are we dragging anchor? Or did it break, or what's going on? We gotta figure that out.
So once we got on the boat, that was only 20% of the challenge. Now we had to assess the situation and figure out how to get her back to shore.
Well, it's definitely an adventure.
Yes, boating wouldn't be fun without adventures, right? Just glad this girl didn't lose. We didn't lose her.
This thing is over today, what it looked like.
I thought it was done already.
Me too.
All right, so I don't know how good the audio is gonna be out here with the wind and all that stuff, but we're gonna figure out if we drag an anchor, if it's still hooked up, so. See if we can start this thing up real quick and do some troubleshooting.
The wind was blowing so hard against us, at least 40 knots, that Monty had the engine going full blast and we were only moving at 1 knot per hour. And a few points we were actually even losing ground. There was a little panic starting to set in on both of us. Monty had two anchors attached to the line that we had to pull up manually, and that was hard. He drove the boat toward the anchor to give me a little bit of slack so I could pull the chain up on the boat. I realized right here that I put the anchor on the wrong side, so I had to drop it back down and bring it up through the middle of the boat, while not trying to lose some toes and fingers. All right, we got the second anchor up, and now we started the long haul in at 1 knot per hour. And just to add a little excitement to the situation, there were some sandbars in the area that were only 1 foot under the water.
Narrow channel that we get squeezed through here without hitting the bottom, so we're trying to do that. As we hit the bottom, we're gonna get stuck. We're going 2 knots right now. Fred might be letting up a little bit, I don't know.
It took us about 45 minutes to get back into the safe anchorage where we drop the anchor and start drifting again, so we had to pull it up and repeat the process. On our third attempt, Monty dove down and checked the anchor and everything was good.
Touch the tree. Are you touching it?
I'm touching it. I can feel it.
All right, I think we got a good anchor. We're gonna hook up the bridle. I got 5% left on my GoPro battery, so I'm gonna record only the stuff that we need.
All right, so before we head back to shore to civilization, we got this thing locked down and wrapped up. What a great story, a great memory, a great experience, right? This is boat life, man.
Oh, boy.
That's what it's all about.
Oh, man.
Glad we saved your boat.
Hey, this guy right here, I wouldn't have been able to do it without an amazing man, amazing family, good people.
Let's do it, man.
Thank you.
That's what we're looking for.
Are you gonna swim?
It was crazy because once the boat was secure and we knew everything was safe, the adrenaline left our bodies. We started shaking and shivering and we knew it was time to get into shore.
You guys did it. Oh, no. We're gonna tip over.
All right, we made it.
What?
Oh, yeah. We made it.
I don't even know where I am right now. Amazing people, man.
We're glad.
Get out there and try something new. We definitely did it today. Woo!
Oh, my God.